I did not check the Google Doc. I probably should have checked the Google Doc.
You checked it. I made so many changes. It's fine. You know what? It's fine. It's fine. You do the tab number next time. We gotta leave them one more.
I didn't bring any other shoes.
You took the bus here.
Yeah.
Hello and welcome. My name is Maddie.
And I'm Ned.
And we are brothers.
We are brothers.
And we are the first bisexual family car dealership.
Good Schaumburg Auto.
Schaumburg Auto. We'll stop our selling you a car. Goodbye, by the way. We're gay.
That jingle is supposed to be we're bisexual, but our dad made the jingle in 2003, and bisexuality was not invented then.
But it's okay, because we're here and we're hosting the Chicago State Monologue Competition.
First annual! And we're there's going to be six people performing six of the best monologuists in the city.
Yeah, in the state of Chicago, more specific.
Chicago is a city, not a state.
I'm pretty sure Chicago's a state.
No.
It's big.
That is not when it happens. It's a city. Illinois is the state.
It's kind of like a state of mind, Chicago. It could be.
Close your eyes. We are the show. Snap. Don't snap.
Snap. Thank you.
Snap during the show.
You can do what they want.
Okay. This show is in honor of our dead bisexual mom.
This is her performance.
We're hosting the show in honor of her. She passed away last week.
She did. Her bones were very heavy because she just couldn't stop that woman from drinking milk.
And she drank so much milk that her bones calcified and were solid. And they were so heavy that they pinned her to the ground.
And she died that way.
Yeah, it rendered her into a coma and she died by being pinned to the ground by heavy bones.
But we're getting sidetracked. She loved acting, which is why we're here. This night is in honor of her.
It's in honor of her. And we love her. We love her so much. And she loved acting. She loved monologues specifically.
And I even moved to New York for a little bit because she loved acting so much. I tried to become a good big Broadway actor. Didn't really work out. I got a Charmin ad though.
Yeah, you were a guy who did not wipe enough.
I was. But I had to move back since then, so I'm running the bisexual family business.
I mean, Ned's not going to tell you this, but Ned doesn't know how to read.
I can read.
That's why it didn't work out.
I just don't read a lot in front of you.
If you want to be an actor, you got to be able to read.
I went to school. I know how to read.
So the rules of tonight is each actor will have 6 minutes to give their best, very best monologue to us and woo us with their amazing talents. And we will rank them all, every single one of them, and then we'll choose two to advance to the final round where they will get a brand new monologue they have never seen before, and they'll have to perform it for you tonight. And then we will announce one single winner.
And they will not only get the title of Chicago State's best monologuist, but also 23% off a used car at Good Schaumburg Automotive!
kept long on the jewels. Okay, well, I'm sick of hearing our voices.
Same here. So let's bring out our first monologuist, Jake Prizant. Woo!
I'm 6 feet tall. I am willing to shave. Here are my hands. Currently a senior at Glenbrook North High School. Go Spartans. The piece I'm going to do today is from the YouTube video entitled Oculus Quest 2 Unboxing and Honest Review. And you already know. I'm coming at you with yet another unboxing video. Today, I'm gonna be digging into the Oculus Quest 2 from Facebook. If you wanna be seeing more unboxing videos, make sure to like and comment. And subscribe for notifications on the different types of videos I post. As a reminder, I post a new video every single Monday. So without further ado, let's get into it. I picked up the Oculus Quest 2, 64 gigabyte for $299. There is also an option to pick up a 280 gigabyte Oculus Quest 2, which will quadruple the amount of storage you have on there. But I chose the $299 option. Because I thought that was a really good deal. Alright, let's get ready. Right off the bat, the packaging looks beautiful. No one can do it like Apple, but for a Facebook product, this is actually really nice. On the back, it tells you what you will get inside. It comes with a Oculus 2 headset, two touch controllers, a USB charging device, two AA batteries, and a user manual. So without any further ado, let's get right into it, boys. Use an X-Acto knife. And if you have one of these, make sure you ask a parent before you use it. I don't know if this is just me. Sound off in the comments if you also love the smell of plastic. Maybe that's just sort of a weird thing I like. But boys, make sure to comment below if you also like that. Oh, wow. Oh, gosh. So yeah, right off the bat, amazing packaging for a Facebook product. It's all separated really nicely. Ooh, I really like the way they did this. This is actually super nice. So, my honest review is that the packaging looks super good, but I'm going to need some time to play with this before I tell you about it. So, make sure you tune in next week for when I spend the whole week in virtual reality. And then I'll be able to tell you my thoughts. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Ned's taking a shit. Ned! You alright?
I got a nosebleed from it.
You good?
Yeah, I'm great.
I was gonna do something from a doll's house, but I thought this would be a little better.
Can we bring up the rubric, please?
I also read half of Blatch Menagerie and got bored waiting for the boy part.
I'll take this. Thank you, Jake Prizant. That was life-changing and interesting. And now we would like to introduce how we'll be judging this.
Yeah. Do you want me to stay here?
Yes,
please. Just stay right there.
Okay. Yes, please. We thought it'd be a good example. So, okay. In your program, you'll see that there's a rubric. A lot of you have already asked me questions about it, which is interesting. And so, basically, all of the judging criteria for this show is based on things that our dead bisexual mom loved.
Yeah. Illinois did give us, like, a rubric they wanted us to use, but we thought this one fit better.
Yeah, we made our own. So, the first category,
characterization. So this is stuff like prop work, accents that don't make us want to kick you off stage.
Yeah, not offensive like accents.
That. Yeah. And how did you feel?
How did you feel, Jake?
So, Jake, I like that you really embodied the character of someone who was opening package.
I thought
the actions were good, but I thought
it's actually in the scripts, which is crazy. That character choice was totally in the script. I can't take much credit for that.
Oh, so
okay.
Maybe that's
deductible. So, I would say at 2 because I would like to see an exact number. If you could have used props.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yes, we're gonna go ahead with 2 points on that
2 points for characterization. Next slide, please.
Yeah. So next category.
Physical beauty.
Our mom loved hot people.
Sort of like people who make you go, oh, ooga, 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 ooga.
Wow.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. So we'll be touching on that. And I'm going to be honest with you, I think you're the ugliest person I've ever seen.
I think you got to think about how mom.
Mom would
think you're a looker. Yeah, mom would think you're probably the handsomest person.
Okay.
Mom would be like, ay, caramba!
Yeah, and then her mouth just dropped to the floor.
So, 5?
Yeah, 5.
5
okay. Points for physical beauty. Love in our last.
Next category.
Did we cry? Mom loves crying. She thought, if I cry, I can emotionally connect. Did you cry?
I did not cry, so that's going to be a 0 on that.
Yeah, I didn't cry either, so 0 points.
So, oh shit, we accidentally did it.
My name is Lillian Stone, and tonight I'll be performing performing Abraham Lincoln rehearsing the Gettysburg Address while his wife Mary Todd Lincoln is getting undressed in front of him. Four score and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created. Dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. Yes. Now, we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation or any nation so conceived and so dedicated may long endure. Yes, we are Mary Todd, really, is that a new hoop skirt? I thought so. You look good. Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing with this war. Oh, we are met. We are met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field to those who have perished here. Yes, we have come to dedicate a portion of that field to those who here gave their lives that this nation might live. And it is altogether fitting that we should do this, but in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate. Mary Todd, what rhymes with dedicate? Consecrate. We cannot hallow this ground, for those who struggled here, living and dead, have hallowed it far above what we can ever hope to achieve. Good mom, look at those things swaggering. The world may little nibble note. The world may little note what we long remember, what we remember. The world may little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did there.
I'm not gonna forget what you are doing because I was nasty, sister. You better stop. I've got my remarks.
The world may little note. No, I'm scared. It is for us, the living, rather, to dedicate ourselves to the unfinished task before us, to ensure, oh my God, I can't even look at you. It's rather for us to ensure that they have not died in vain, that this nation under God will have a new birth of freedom, and that our nation of the people, by the people, and for the people, shall not perish from the earth. Come here, nasty girl.
Okay, real quick, our producer said that
the show is not interesting enough.
It's true,
so
they did say that.
We're gonna go ahead and do like a hot one sort of thing.
Bitch, I am the one. So how could I lose? Swing on that bitch like a hammock. I'm doing me. She cannot stand it. He see me in person in panic. He know that I'm bad and I'm rude. It get hot, so I'm keeping it cool. But he like how I get in my mood. So why would you fuck with my mental? Told you I've been through. Oh, cause you was my heart, so I let you? Cause you was my heart, so I let you. After all that, you should have told me. Fuck that, I'm on my dolly. Fuck that, I'm going OD. Would violate, but that was the old me. You would have thought that I missed you. But you was a thought, that's the issue. Your bro is the one that I went to. He gave me Mozzie in the rental. And you did me dirt. Cause what did I do? Like I fucked on your bro, but I could not choose. No loving a smooch. Bitch, I am the one. So how can I lose? Like, swing on that bitch like a hammock. I'm doing me. She cannot stand it. I don't fuck with a nigga that stays in the likes of a bitch I don't like. She must be a bait, cause you always bite. That shit gets me tight. And it's not okay when you try to hurt me while we're fucking off perkies. We both from the Bronx, so I know that you're dirty. How you do me like that? When I fought you fight back? I thought you knew I was a bully. Never understood me fully. They should have named me Pressure. Who you know that do it better? You gon' think about me till forever. You did me dirt. Cause what did I do? Like I fucked on your bro, but I could not choose. No loving a smooch. Bitch, I am the one. So how can I lose? Swing on that bitch like a hammock. I'm doing me. She cannot stand it. Thank you.
Wow. I think it's safe to say the hand tracing gets a 6.
There were no props.
Oh, one. Honestly, I'm getting fucking sick of not seeing any props up here. I'm sorry, it was good, but there was a...
That's a big dump. No one to like.
Okay, so the actor has sent notes.
I was thinking about bumping them up to like a 3, but yeah, actors should not have notes.
No.
Beauty?
I mean, that's still a 5.
Still a 5,
unfortunately.
Yeah.
You can't argue with God.
Yeah, no.
Who's real?
That is true. did you cry?
I did. I was sobbing. Sobbing.
But physical tears?
No.
Okay. Neither did I.
I mean...
Yeah, 3 is a nice round.
3.75
is a good one.
3.8. What the fuck? What do you want? You want more?
Yeah.
More?
Yeah.
9?
Yeah!
There's not a 9 on this fucking board! So you think that okay, 9. I shouldn't yell at the audience. I've been kicked out of the Golden Corral enough to know that I shouldn't yell. I shouldn't want to support me. I'm sorry.
I forgive you.
Thank you. Go tonight.
Are you okay?
Yep. Yeah, thank you.
Should I go to you?
No, yeah. You're good. You're good. Get off stage. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, hold on. We have a bit. In the trash can.
I can try to put it back in order.
Yeah, I just. Sorry, I'm a little.
You don't need these.
Oh my god.
You can announce the next person without them.
I don't know what I'm bringing.
You can do it.
I know fucking clue.
You can do it. You've been relying too hard on those things.
Yeah, I just. I don't know what to do. I'm not acting like you. I've never fucking done this. I have no idea.
Just remember, it was right in front of you. You were on the right note card.
The next performer is Jesus Christ.
Everybody, give it up for Gimmick the Drag King.
We are required to inform you that the monologist you are about to watch is illegal in some states, more than 69 countries. Nice. And in 12 of those countries, their crimes are even punishable by death. Less nice. Worst of all, their most dastardly deed is being a sexy little silly goose. You've been warned.
Thank you for requesting this demo of the new HRTV set. The only television perfectly queer-coded to alter any hateful rhetoric. So the only transmissions you receive align with the transmission. Since this is a demonstration, I will be in charge of the remote. Let's see what happens when we turn on Fox News.
Laura Ingraham has finally picked a drag name. Her drag king persona will now be known as Holden Income. She wants to remind you and stand her lines out of the gutter. Drag is not inherently sexual. Holden Income is how she expresses herself, since she is in the 1% who are known for withholding income. Over to you, best Bestie.
Thanks, Quinn. In other news, a celebrity has issued an apology. She shall not be named, said sorry, as part of the Say Yay Not Nay to Gay campaign. The apology came today in an essay penned by JK. Their repartee conveyed the following. Okay, trans today's slay. How's my Monet? The lady has promised to pay every trans, hey, shay, and they. We eagerly await the payday. Back to you, bestie.
Thanks, fam. I love you. Now, on to our top story of the night. Elliot Page. And our bottom story of the night is Sam Smith. He doesn't really have that energy. Other top stories include Aubrey Plaza, the brawny towel guy, and electrical cords. While bottoms include Ben Platt, Mr. Clean, and electrical sockets.
Hope you enjoyed the new and improved Fox News. Now, let's see what's happening over at C-SPAN's live coverage of CPAC.
Welcome to the What's Wrong with Our Country panel. We each start by introducing our stances. I believe that there's a growing issue in our nation that must be eradicated, and that is, we aren't talking about our attachment styles enough. Astrological signs. But can we really improve as a country until we can say that maybe the reason I'm not okay with socialism is because I'm avoidant?
5 years to renounce problematic surgery. I'm talking Uber surge prices, storm surges, and surge, the soda from the 90s. It's just unnatural.
And I'm here to talk about something truly ungodly. Why are nuns' habits so long you can't even see their feet? They just look like they're floating, and I can't tell if I'm seeing a real nun or a ghost nun. It's not right.
Finally, politicians talking about the issues that matter. But what about something a bit more entertaining? Let's check out some popular scenes from movies and TV shows.
Chandler, we still haven't gotten our speech.
Mother.
Oh, right. Maybe that's because
she's so obsessed with Jennifer Coolidge, it's embarrassing.
Chandler.
Your mother.
Could be at your wedding.
I don't even know
her.
Okay, we're not that close. I haven't seen
her
in years.
What are you gonna do?
She.
Find her.
She.
Wasn't even asked.
Well,
she
doesn't have to know. It's not like we run in the same circles. I hang out with you guys and
she says things like,
oh, it's the Botox. You can't show emotion for another hour and a half.
I think I want to trade circles.
Trust me, you don't want
her
there either, okay? Nobody's gonna be staring at the bride when the
mother
or the groom
tells people,
you look like the 4th of July. Makes me want a hot dog real bad.
What? I love
she.
I'm not wearing a white dress and a veil. I don't care. Okay, I think I need to do some shopping.
You know what? I'm in a
one so out of my league.
This isn't helping me, man.
What? Okay, well, how did you know that she was
so cool?
Because
he supported live comedy and drag.
Hey, buddy. There's a bunch of models in the lobby, and the gossip is one of them is really
into Back to the Future.
God. It's always the one.
Calvin Klein?
No, I don't want to play.
That concludes today's demo. We hope you enjoyed this selection of programming, especially since here at HRTV, we believe that trans joy is trans resistance. Life is meant to be enjoyed in abundance. So live long and live well, you sexy little silly geese. Woo!
That was great!
got prop work.
We got props. We got costumes.
We got abs.
We got abs.
I mean, I don't want to speak too soon.
Speak soon.
I want to say at least the first two fives.
Five. What do you say to that? Oh. However, I didn't hear your voice.
Technically, the whole thing was my voice.
Okay, fine. Fuck me for even asking. Typical. Okay, did we cry?
Yeah, pull my underwear.
I got something in my eye and it made me kind of water.
I definitely cried a little bit, so I would say probably a seven? What do you think?
I think I cried.
Eight. Thank you. How's it been?
Are you okay? You're sitting down now?
I just why'd you rip on my note cards?
You don't need them.
I do.
Get that thought out.
I'm looking at you.
No, look, really see me. Look at me. You can do this without those note cards.
I didn't want to do this.
Don't say that.
You said we had to do it for mom.
We are doing it for mom. Bisexual mom.
I'm so fucking scared right now. Every single person here wants me fucking dead.
Take that energy and fuel it. Throw back at them. Kill them, not you. Got it. Come on. Do it.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
Do it now. Do it.
Please.
Can you do it now?
Please put your hands together.
You're on a time schedule.
Please put your hands together. Please put your hands together for the next. Please put
your hands
together.
Are you going to do it? Do it.
Fucking
Chloe Mikala, everybody.
Yes, in season 2, episode 5, Bring the Pain, from none other than Grey's Anatomy, hashtag Big Shonda Proud.
Ha ha ha!
pain. It comes in all forms. A small twinge, a bit of soreness, a random pain. The normal pains that we live with every day.
Seriously! Seriously!
But then, there's a kind of pain you can't ignore. A level of pain so great that it blocks out everything else. Makes your entire world fade away until all you can think about is how much you hurt. And how we manage our pain is up to us.
Seriously! Seriously! He's a brain surgeon! He's a brain surgeon! How could he be so brainless? Seriously!
Hey, we anesthetize it, write it out, embrace it, ignore it. And for some, the best way to manage pain is to just push through it. Trust me, it's not.
Claire!
Thank you.
I've never seen that.
Do you like Schitt's Creek?
No, it's season 2, episode 4.
Well, I liked it.
I thought it was good.
I thought it was just fine.
And yeah. The props? I mean, that's a commitment to that blood. Blood right there. You know,
I say an exception. Six.
I say six.
I say six.
Physical beauty.
The blood, I think the blood kind of grosses me out.
Too. I'm not. Just, I might pass out.
So we might have to deduct a couple points for that.
Yeah. So I'd say two.
Yeah, two's fine. Two's good.
Two? And did we cry? I was close. I was about to bust.
I
was about to.
Oh my god.
It was gonna be wet. Thank you.
Bisexual mom loves you.
Yeah.
You just gotta go out there and you just gotta do it.
Hi. This show is the best show on the planet. And the show is sponsored by Good Schomburg Auto.
Good Schomburg
Auto.
You'll get a car that goes pretty far. We hate our dad cause he's really bad. But our mom is cool, that's why we're doing this show. He was a dad that we barely knew. Fuck you.
Okay, give it up for your next guest. My dad. Give it up for your next guest. Bridget Broderick. Give it up. Give it up for the next guest. Barack Obama.
Nice.
Give it up for the next. Wait a minute.
Take a breath.
Okay. Give it up for your next guest, Moriah Tisby.
All right, right?
I'm okay.
Okay, we can do it. We're gonna go. We're gonna leave you. You're good, right?
Yeah. I'm gonna stay.
Transportation. Okay. Stay.
Okay.
like an Ambien, and so I didn't get to go over any of my lines. So I need you. Hi, I'm Miss Tisby. I just need you to stay on book. And if I call the line, just like give me the line. You don't need to read what's in red. That was like for myself. And now normally in Australia, when I do this monologue, I am allowed to have a gun. Guess not.
Hey,
that's our one thing.
Which is why I brought a ladle. This is my gun because my monologue involves firearms. So, it also involves someone throwing something at me. It's technically supposed to be a breakaway glass. But I don't have that, so I grabbed a bottle of pills. And I need one of you, at the end of my monologue, what's going to happen is I'm going to say to teach and guide him. That's when you're going to throw that bottle of pills at my head. I need you to aim for my head. It's okay if you miss and hit my face. It's okay. We're all working with it here. Okay, and you, yeah. I need you to stand, like, right there. Yeah. Like, normally when I do this monologue, I'm like doing it with my mom. Rest in peace to your mom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That means a lot.
Yeah, she was bisexual.
That's amazing.
Thank you.
So like, I need you to pretend this would be a gun.
Okay.
Okay, I will be pointing it at you the whole time. Can you hold my inhaler? Thank you so much. It's fine, it's not dirty. It's fine.
I didn't think it was dirty.
Your eyes.
Hey, Pete.
Said it was
dirty.
This is not a...
Okay. Sorry, I'm asleep. Hi, my name is Moriah Tisby, and I will be doing the Mother's Love monologue from Scream 2. And again, I'm from Australia, so I will be doing an American accent. Okay, line? Are you saying no is the line? Or
yeah,
are you saying
no is the line?
No
is the line.
No is the line. Got it. Okay, that wasn't what I thought it was. Okay. Sorry. So this is a gun. One shot at you. questions? Have I covered everything? Any comments? Well, who gives a flying fuck anyways? Let them line.
Try and track down the second possible killer.
Let them try and track down the second possible killer. Demi Salt does not exist. Line.
What did you just say?
Is that my line?
Her line is, you're as crazy as your son was. And then you go, what did you just say?
Oh, yeah.
Can you say that?
Yeah, can you say that?
You are as crazy as your son was.
What did you say? Was that a negative, disparaging remark about my son? About my Billy? My God damn it. Oh, yes. Sorry, can you say that?
No, Billy was a bang-up job. He did a good job raising him.
Oh, it's not wise to patronize me when I have a gun. It's not wise, is it? So listen up. You don't know. What is the law? Say that again.
Randy spoke poorly.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Randy spoke poorly of Billy, and I got a little knife happy. Huh? I got a little knife happy. That's good. Okay. What's the law?
I was a good mother.
I was a good mother. You don't know what it's like to be a mother, to have a child, to love him, to teach him, to guide him. Ow!
Everyone here has been so sexy. Yeah. Everyone has been so good.
And it looks like our...
Stop the show! Stop the show! I'm not actually dead! I'm not dead! Mom! That's bisexual, they see,
Mom. What are you doing?
Yeah, Mom, you're alive?
The doctor said you were legally dead last week, that your bones were so heavy from all the milk.
They fell through your house.
They were so heavy, but they found a way how to rehollow my bones. They said, shut up. They said, shut up. As long as you don't drink any more milk, you're fine.
What? And then,
yeah.
Get up here, you dumbass. Get up here, Mom.
There's one option, there's one thing we can do, I guess.